So if you see the output side, that output voltage is represented as G21 V1 and G22 I2. Then if you concentrate on this one, G22, then that is like an impedance. Okay, then this is like one voltage added with the another voltage. Okay, so that's why I can put like this. Okay, this is the dependent voltage, that is G21 V1. Again, voltage has to be added. That's why I will put that impedance. Okay, now that G22 is the impedance, that I will put it in the series. Okay, then here it is like this. Then I2 goes like this and plus minus V2. So I2 multiplied with G22 plus G21 V1, which is equal to V2. Okay, so next one, ABCD parameter. Yeah, this is very important parameter. Most probably in the exam you will get the question based on the ABCD parameter or T parameter. So that ABCD parameter is V1 is equal to AV2 plus minus BI2, then I1 is equal to CV2 minus DI2. Again, don't get confusion why they are using minus here. Okay, so even though they are using minus, it doesn't mean that B is minus. Okay, B may be minus or plus, we do not know, but don't think that whenever minus is there, that B value is minus. Similarly, whenever minus is there, D value is. Okay, you just think it like this, in this manner. Okay, whenever this equation is there, you just think it like this. Okay, so that means what? When you apply the definition, instead of taking I2, you have to take minus I2. You have to take minus I2. So for example, what is the definition here? A is equal to V1 by V2. Then again, you take I2 as 0 or minus I2 as 0. See, actually you have to take minus I2 as 0. When minus I2 is 0, I2 is also what? 0 only. So no problem. So you can take like this. So I2 as 0. Okay, now then what is C means I1 divided by V2, that time I2 is equal to 0. But now when you write the remaining parameter, you have to be a little bit careful. Okay, then what is B? B is equal to, okay, B is equal V1 divided by, it's not I2, it's V1 divided by minus I2. It's not I2. That is minus I2. Okay, by definition, you have to calculate what is V1 by I2. V1 by minus I2. So you have to calculate this one. Okay, so then you have to get the quantity. Similarly, for D, you have to calculate what is I1 divided by minus I2. Okay, then you have to write the quantity. So this is the only difference here. Here you will get minus here. Accordingly, this will vary. Okay, so you have to keep it in mind. Okay, this is because mostly the ABCD parameter, or the other name for ABCD parameter is T parameter. Okay, mostly the ABCD parameter or T parameter will be used for transformers or transmission lines. Okay, so suppose for a transformer we are using this parameter. Okay, what is happening for a transformer? This we will write it as V1, this we'll write it as I1. Again, V2 is there. But what will happen in the transformer? Actually, we'll put I2 in this direction. But with respect to transformer also, we'll put I2 in this direction. But what is the real current? What is the real load current? The real load current will flow in this direction. The real current will flow in this direction. Then we put the notation like this. That's why we'll put minus here, so that we'll get the positive quantity. So in reality, the transformer, the actual current will be going always to the load. But we put, by convention, we are putting like this. Okay, that means what is the current going to the load? The current going to the load actually is minus I2. The current going to the load is actually minus I2. That is the idea. That's why for a ABCD parameter alone, we'll put a minus here. Then again, if you see, what is this A? This A is like reverse voltage gain with the open circuit at the output. This B is like again V1 by I2. So once if you forget about that minus quantity, this is like reverse impedance. This is like forward admittance. Okay, this is like reverse current gain. Okay, reverse current gain. Okay. So next inverse ABCD parameter. A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash. Inverse ABCD parameter. Then first you should know what is the ABCD parameter. You write it separately here. ABCD parameter is V1 is equal to A V2 minus B I2, and then I1 is equal to C V2 minus D I2. Then how to write inverse ABCD parameter here? Here for G and H parameter, we have just replaced the voltage and current. Okay, we have just replaced the voltage and current, but here we are doing in opposite manner. It's by definition, say for example, this is V2. Okay, then A V1 and B I1 and I2 is C V1 and D I1. Again put dash. Okay, so what is the change here? Here instead of changing the voltage and the current, here we are changing the subscript. Okay, if 2 is there, you put 1. If 1 is there, you put 2. Then again you put, if A is there, you put A dash. If B is there, you put B dash. Okay, so this is the change here. So this is the inverse ABCD parameter. Okay, it's all by definition. We cannot question here. Okay, so these are all the like standard equations. Okay, so then what is A dash? A dash is equal to V2 divided by V1 when I1 is equal to 0. And then what is C dash? That is I2 divided by V1 when I1 is equal to 0. What is B? V2 divided by minus I2 then V1 is equal to 0. What is D? I2 divided by minus I1 when V1 is equal to 0. Again, so we have written the basic equations for all the six parameters, but out of these six parameters, mostly for exam point of view, Z parameter and Y parameter, okay, then H parameter and ABCD parameter only we'll be discussing. Okay, out of all these six parameters, only we'll be discussing these four parameters. Okay, so now again, before going to that, we'll see some basics. Okay, something related with symmetric network or unsymmetric network, because when you write the Z parameter or any parameter you write, okay, then it is represented as a matrix. Say for example, suppose if you write Z parameter, Z11, Z12, Z21, Z22. Again, you know from the basics of matrix, we are having some properties. Sometime this diagonal may be same or this diagonal may be same, or sometime for some matrix, if you take mod, then that will be equal to 1. Okay, so there are some possibilities are there. So whenever you take some network, some proper network, say symmetrical network, then it will follow, the matrix also will follow some condition. So once by, again, by looking at the matrix, you can easily tell what is the properties of the network. What is the properties? Okay, so there is the relation between this matrix and also with the structure of the network and also the element present in the network. That's why we'll see what is symmetric and unsymmetrical network. Okay, so first we'll see the unsymmetric network. Okay, unsymmetric in the sense, when you see the network physically from the left side or from the right side, okay, if they are looking same, okay, if they are looking same, then that is called unsymmetric network. Say for example, if you are having Z A here, okay, then another impedance Z C here, and here you are having Z B. Okay, here you are having Z B. Then what is the nature of the network? Okay, if you see from this side, anyway, this is Z C is common. but you are seeing Z A here. But once if you see here, Z C is common, but you are seeing Z B. So when you look from left side and right side, it, visually this is looking different. That's why this network is called unsymmetric network. This unsymmetric network. And then what is the example for symmetric network? Symmetric network. So if it has to be symmetric network, then values here has to be same. Whatever the value is present here, that has to be same. So that means if you use ZA here, again, you use any ZC, no problem, because that is common to both input and output. Then here also you have to use ZA. Then this network is called symmetric network. This network is called symmetric network. The same thing you can put in pi model also. Okay, so you use some value here, some value here. Okay, with respect to pi. Okay, so suppose if it is Z2, if it is Z1, Z3, then this is unsymmetric. Whereas if you use Z2 here and Z1 here, here also if you use Z1, then that is symmetric network. That is symmetric network. So now you know what is the difference between symmetric and unsymmetric network. And also, again, you should know what is the reciprocal network. Okay, so any idea about reciprocal network? Anybody? What do you mean by reciprocal network? Any idea? Already we have discussed this. What do you mean by reciprocal network?
Z12.
No, and parameter lang kekala. In general, what is it?
If you interchange the port, the current remains same.
The response remains same. Okay, so what is the reciprocal network? If you are having network like this, say this port, I will call it as a port. This port, I will call it as a B port. Okay, now I am giving some source here, V1. Okay, then I measure some load is there here. I measure some current here. Okay, I am giving some voltage. I am getting some current. Okay, so the same thing, even if I interchange the network, okay, even if I interchange the network, that means I am bringing the okay, I am interchanging. What I am interchanging, see, again, it's useless, because if I bring my voltage here, okay, so what they are telling, you keep the network as it is. Okay, you keep the network as it is. Say this is A terminal, this is A, and again this is B. Now you connect your source here. Okay, you connect whatever the load present here, you connect it here. Now you will get the same current what you are getting here. You will get the same current here. Then once this is okay, then this is called as reciprocal network. Again, this network need not to be symmetrical. This network need not to be symmetrical. Okay, this network may be unsymmetric. Okay, the network may be unsymmetric, but the network has to be reciprocal. Then which network is called reciprocal network? If network consists of only resistor, network consists of only resistor, network consists of only resistor, that network will act as a reciprocal network. Okay, the network, okay, if the network is made up of only resistor, again, it need not to be a symmetrical one. It can be in any manner, unsymmetric. Okay, the network will act as a reciprocal network. That is the idea of the reciprocal network. That is the idea of the network, reciprocal. Or, otherwise, you can do this operation like this also. You are not changing your input. You are keeping your input as it is. But what you are doing, okay, you are interchanging the network. You can do like that also. You interchange the network. Again, instead of here, A terminal, you bring the B terminal. Again, instead of here, you bring the A terminal. You are keeping your voltage source as it is. Again, you are keeping your current source as it is. Then now across the, your load, then what will be the current across the load? The current will be I. Again, it's useless, because if you see, if you imagine properly, both are same. If you imagine properly, both are same. Is it not, sir? In the rendu diagram same ah varyingla sir? B is here, V is here, B is here, B is here, A is here, ZL is here. Okay, so all are same. These two diagram is same. Okay, so please imagine and observe it. Okay, whether you interchange the input and output or whether you flip the network, no problem. Okay, it will work in the reciprocal case. It will work in the reciprocal case. Okay, so now next we should know what is the reciprocal network. If the network consists of only resistor, then that network is called reciprocal network. So once if the network is reciprocal, then this matrix will follow some condition. Okay, again, the condition may be different in different parameter, but we'll see that what are all the conditions. Okay, so then again, now as per our discussion, okay, the network may be symmetric. Okay, the network is symmetric, or the network may be reciprocal, or sometime the network may be both symmetric and reciprocal. Okay, so then once this is the case, if the network is symmetry, okay, if the network is symmetry, what is the condition that we have to satisfy? Okay, so now suppose if you are using Z parameter, if the network is symmetric, then the value of Z11, the value of Z11 has to be is equal to value of Z11 is equal to Z22. Okay, I'm not worried about other parameters. If Z11 is equal to Z22, then that network is symmetric network. And again, the network may consist of what? Even the dependent sources that I'm not worried about. Okay, then once if this condition is true, that network is symmetric network. Whereas for a reciprocal network, Z12 is equal to Z21, Z12 is equal to Z21. If the network consists of only resistors, definitely that network will satisfy this property, because all resistive networks are reciprocal network. Then definitely it will satisfy this. Okay, if the network consists of extra element such as dependent sources, then it may not satisfy the reciprocal properties. Okay, so then in case of Y11, that is Y11, Y22 and Y12, Y21. Okay, then for H parameter, this is H11, H22 minus H12, H21 is equal to 1. Whereas for reciprocity, H12 is equal to minus H21. And then here, in terms of ABCD parameter, A is equal to D. Here, AD minus BC is equal to 1. Okay, most probably in the exam, okay, mostly in the exam point of view, this is very, very important. Okay, the next to that, again, they may ask H parameter, then only they will ask the remaining parameter. Okay, so this you have to remember, okay, for a Z parameter, Y parameter, and H and ABCD parameter, what is the condition for symmetric? What is the condition for reciprocity? Okay, so again, if you see the first two conditions, they are same. Okay, they are same. Again, these two is little bit different. Okay, here A is equal to T, but here opposite. Okay, it comes in the opposite manner, but with the negative sign. And again, this is looking somewhat same. Okay, again, if you write it as the matrix, then you'll come to know. Okay, it's like diagonal product minus remaining diagonal product is equal to 1. This is also same like that. Okay, so you have to remember this result. Okay, then one more relationship between the parameters are, once if you know Z parameter, you can easily find out what is the Y parameter. Okay, if you know Z parameter, you can easily find out Y parameter by doing the matrix inverse. If you take the matrix inverse, okay, from the Z parameter, you can find out the Y parameter. Similarly, if you know the Y parameter, if you do the inverse, then you can get the Z parameter. So for a given network, once if you have calculated any one of the parameter, okay, then you can easily calculate the other parameter. If you calculate Z parameter, you can easily calculate what is Y with respect to matrix inverse. Similarly, once if you calculate Y directly, you can calculate what is Z parameter of that particular network. This is one simple idea. Or otherwise, even we can calculate from one parameter to another parameter. There are some little steps are there that we have to follow. That means what I'm telling, once if you have Z parameter, okay, equations, okay, without doing anything from this equation itself, you can write Y parameter. Okay, you can write what is the other parameter? You can write H parameter. You can write ABCD parameter. Okay, so with some simple modification, once if you have any one of the parameter, you can write any other parameter. Okay, but you should know the standard equations. Okay, by doing some modification, you can get all the parameters. Okay, so for a given network, if you have any one of the parameter, you can easily calculate the other parameters with some modifications in the equations. Okay, that also we'll see in future. So next, first we'll take the basic circuit, then we'll find out the Z parameter for that circuit. Okay, so Z parameter. Now the circuit is like this. Okay, it is like a T network. It is Z A and Z B and Z C. Again, if you see this here, this is V1, voltage V1. Okay, this is voltage V2. Again, this is the current entering I1. This is the current entering I2. Now my aim is V1 I have to represent in terms of I1 and I2. V2 I have to represent in terms of I1 and I2. Say for example, what is the standard equation is telling? V1 is equal to Z11 I1, Z12 I2, V2 is equal to Z21 I1, Z22 I2. Somehow I have to make this equation. Okay, so again, I can also go by open circuit method and short circuit method. Later I will do that. But before going to that method, okay, before going to that, I will solve it by ordinary procedure. Okay, here do not short circuit, do not open circuit anything. You simply apply KVL or KCL for the circuit. Okay, there are many ways to get the parameters. Okay, now this procedure is, in this procedure, do not make open circuit or do not make short circuit. Okay, keep the circuit as it is. Now you apply the KVL, Kirchhoff voltage law. See, when I1 is coming here, what is the current here? I1 is coming in this way, I2 is coming this way. Then this is I1 plus I2. Then you apply KVL in the first loop. You apply the KVL in the second loop. Then what you are getting? V1 is equal to Z A, Z A I1, Z B I1, Z B I2. Then how can I write? This is Z A plus Z B I1 plus Z B I2. Similarly, you apply the KVL here. This is V2 is equal to Z C I2, Z B, Z B I1, Z B I2. Then once if you arrange this, this will be Z B I1, this will be Z B plus Z C I2, Z C I2. So once if you compare this equation with the standard equation, okay, so this is like Z A plus Z B into I1. That means Z11 is Z A plus Z B. Then Z12 I2. That means Z12 is equal to Z B and Z21 is equal to Z B. Z22 is equal to Z B plus Z C. So once if they given the network like this, you can apply simply the KVL. Again, please remember this is the general method. We are not following the two-port network method. We are just applying the general method. Okay, just apply the KVL, KCL, then you'll get equations. Then you compare with the original equation. Then finally you'll get the answer. So now what is the answer? Because we can represent the in terms of matrix V1 and V2. And again, this is Z11. That value is Z A plus ZB, and this is ZB, ZB, and this is ZB plus ZC. And this is I1, I1, I2. Okay, now what is the value of Z? Z value is ZA plus ZB and ZB. This is ZB and ZB plus ZC. Okay, so this is the value. Okay, so again, if you further, if you see what is Z11, ZA plus ZB. Again, what is Z12, ZB. Z21 is equal to ZB, Z22 is equal to ZB plus ZC. Sir? Solang, sir.
V2.
Yes, sir. V2. Okay. So again, these are all the Z parameter. Then, so once if the network is like this, it is very simple. So first Z11 means what? Simply you add what is given here. Okay, what is available at the input side? ZA is there, ZB is there. Okay, that quantity will get here. Then what about the next quantity? The next quantity in the matrix is this term. Okay, so this is the common term between the input and output. Okay, again, this is common, ZB. Again, with respect to output, again, this is common. So that's why again, I am writing ZB here. Then with respect to output alone, then what is present in the output network, both ZC and ZB is present in the output network, that I will write it here. Okay, now the question is, once if you are known with this parameter, if you are given with this parameter, then how to represent the network? Say, for example, I know this quantity. Finally, I know Z11, Z12, Z21, Z22. Okay. Now, how to represent, okay, ZA, ZB, and ZC? Okay. It's like in the reverse manner. Okay. Then what is the value of ZA? Now, my question is, say, for example, I'll write it here. This is ZA. And this is ZB. This is ZC. Now we know what is Z11, what is Z22, Z21, Z12, everything we know. Then with respect to that, how to write the network? Okay, now the question is this one. Okay, now I know what is Z11, what is Z12, what is Z21, what is Z22. Okay, so then once if you see, I got Z11 by adding ZA plus ZB. I got Z11 by adding ZA plus ZB. Z12 simply ZB. Z21 simply ZB. Then Z22 is equal to Z21. So that means what? My ZB is same as Z12 or Z21. Okay, so I can write here. Okay, so instead of ZB, I can write here either Z12 or Z21, no problem. Both are same. So I can write it here. But how to write ZA? If you observe these two equations, if you subtract the second equation from the first equation, you will get ZA. That means here I can write Z11 minus Z12. Again, here I need ZC. Okay, I need ZC, then this value is, what is Z22? This value is ZB plus ZC. Okay, then if you see here, then you have to subtract this equation from this equation, then you will get Z22. Okay, Z22 minus Z12 or 21. Okay, this is Z22 minus Z12 or 21, no problem. Okay, so again, first you have calculated what is the Z parameter. Then from the Z parameter, how to construct the network. Okay, so that is the idea. So you are calculating the Z. See, network is given. You have calculated the Z parameter. Again, if you are given with the Z parameter, how to construct the network? How to construct the network? That is the idea here. So, so finally, ZA value is Z11 minus Z12. ZB is equal to Z12 or Z21, ZC is equal to Z22 minus Z12 or Z21. So this is then all about the Z parameter. Okay, then can we find out this quantity with respect to the method given? Okay, what is the, again, we'll try to calculate this with respect to the method given. Okay, whenever Z parameter network is given, okay, say for example, this is ZA, same network only I am taking, ZB, this is ZC, okay, this is the general network format, plus minus V1, I1, plus minus V2, I2, then what is the standard equation? V1 is equal to Z11, I1, okay, Z12, I2, then what is V2? V2 is equal to Z21, I1, Z22, I2. Okay, then once if you see here, if you want to calculate Z11, you have to make I2 as zero. So first I'll make I2 as zero. Again, here you will have some confusion here. What is the meaning of I2 is equal to zero? The moment you get I2 as zero, you just substitute in the diagram that I2 is zero. Okay, because you are making I2 as zero. The moment you have I2 as zero, then you substitute 0 ampere here. I2 is zero. So once if I2 is zero, okay, if it is zero, what is the voltage drop here? That is 0 volt, because zero current is coming. Again, there will be some voltage. That voltage is V2. We are not affecting that voltage. V2 is there, but what we are doing, I2 only we are making zero, because by definition, if you want to calculate Z11, then we need V1 I1 relation. That time I2 is equal to zero. So once if you make I2 is equal to zero, then this is 0 ampere. Again, this is 0 volt. But here, as it is, V1 will be there, I1 will be there. Then you write the KVL here. Okay, once if you write KVL, V1 is equal to, okay, ZA plus ZB only, because you will not get any current from here. You will not get any current. Okay, ZA into ZB into I1. Then you take the ratio V1 by I1. Then what is this? ZA plus ZB. That only we are calling it as Z11. So you do by either that method or this method. Finally, Z11 will be ZA plus ZB. Again, in the given network, what you can find out easily again, Z21 you can find out. For that, you have to make relationship between V2 and I1. Again, it is very simple. You apply the KVL in the outer loop, in this loop. In the second loop, you apply the KVL. You know the voltage here, you know the voltage here, you know the voltage here. Because what is the current going here? I1. Because whatever the current that is coming here, I1, it will flow, because here 0 ampere is the current. Now you apply the KVL in the outer loop. Then once you apply the KVL, K2 is equal to 0 plus, okay, 0 plus ZB into I1. Okay, that is equal to ZB I1. And again, we know that again, the relationship between V2 and I1 is Z21. So that Z21 is equal to simply ZB. Okay, simply ZB. So once if you make I2 as 0, simultaneously, you can calculate what is I1 and also, sorry, what is Z11 and what is Z21. So we have calculated both Z11 and Z21. Okay, Z21. Then you make I1 as 0, then you can calculate what is Z12 and then what is Z22. Okay, again, in the same manner. Okay, so I am putting similarly. Okay, similarly, you make I2 as zero, then you apply the KVL. I1. Okay. So you make I1 as zero. Similarly, you make I1 as zero, then you calculate the rest of the quantity, that is Z12, Z22, Z12 and Z22. That will be definitely Z12 is equal to ZB, Z22 is equal to ZB plus ZC. Again, same thing. Instead of making 0 ampere here, you make 0 ampere here. Then you apply KVL here, KVL here. Then you get two equation. From the two equation, you can get Z12, Z22. So you can go by any method. Okay, so this is, here we are not making any open short. Simply we are applying KVL, KCL. Okay, but finally we have to be, the equation has to be in this format. Then only we can pick up the values from here. If the equation is not coming in this format, okay, so again, we cannot go by this method. So we can go by this method whenever the network is in a standard format. Okay, so if the network is in some other format, okay, it consists of many resistance and in different manners. Okay, if it is connected in different manner, we cannot go by this method. That time, definitely, we have to go by this method only. Okay, if the network is not in the proper format, if it is not in the standard format, we have to go by this method. That means open circuit and short circuit methods. Okay, for Z parameter, we have to do the open circuit. For the Y parameter, we will do short circuit. For H parameter, we'll do both, open, short. Similarly, for ABCD parameter also, we'll do both, open, short. Okay, so we'll see about the rest of the parameters in the next class. Okay.
Yeah.